In this video, I'll first explain how email marketing software get responses, pricing structure works, and furthermore, I'll share my opinion about their most important features. And I'm telling you how much daily bread the company GetResponse makes each hour of the day, which is pretty interesting to know if you're an entrepreneur like me. My name is Robin Klein-Penning, and I'm just a random guy who likes to get up at 5 in the morning to spend time researching and testing software tools so you won't have to. If you want to know more about me and how I earn most of my daily bread, check out this video where I explain how I started and currently run my online dog training business without me being a dog expert. And this business makes me around 15,000 euros in profit each month. So firstly, in this video, I'll start by explaining GetResponse's pricing structure. The second part is me showing their features and my opinion about it. Lastly, part 3 is for the real business people, and in this part I'm telling you how much money GetResponse makes each hour of the day. So pricing, the first part of this video. The most crucial question is, do they have a free plan at the moment? Quick answer, no, they don't. They do offer the option to try out every plan you would like for 30 days, and you don't need to fill in your credit card for that. So that's nice. And if you want to try out GetResponse for free, please do so by going through my affiliate link below. It's in the description, as I will receive a small commission when you do so with no extra cost to you, of course. And if you go through my affiliate link, that will be the end of it.
I will not look for you. I will not pursue you. But if you don't, I will look for you. I will find you.
And I will send you spam email. So GetResponse offers 4 different plans, whereas the 4th plan doesn't have a price point. It's for the enterprise users. The first 3 plans are the basic plan, the plus plan, and the professional plan. And you can choose for a monthly billing cycle, or a 12-month plan, or a 24-month plan. With a 12-month plan, you will receive a 12% discount, and with a 24 plan, you will receive a 30% discount. Most email marketing companies charge you for the number of contacts or subscribers you have in your account. The same goes for GetResponse. Their smallest number of contacts is up to 1,000 contacts, and their basic plan starts at $15 per month. Okay, so the problem with their basic plan is that you only have access to their autoresponder feature and not the automation feature. And more on the automation feature in the 3rd part of this video. In short, you cannot send your list different messages based upon their situation. So for my online dog training business, I have multiple sign-up forms where people can download either a checklist, free chapters of my book, etc. The moment they sign up, I ask them about their situation. They can choose one of the 4 situations or buckets I created. They can choose for either, I don't know if I'm ready for a puppy. The second one is, I'm prepared for a puppy, but don't know the breed yet. And the 3rd one is, I'm waiting to pick up my puppy from the breeder. Or the last one, I have my puppy already at home. And by knowing their situation, I can personalize my messages to them. I'm not going to send people information about different dog breeds if they already have their puppy at home. You get the point. So this is impossible to do if you only use the autoresponder, since you cannot work with tags or other actions inside the autoresponder. You can only do 1 email sequence, and that's it. And in my opinion, email marketing is all about personalization and automation. And without one of these 2, I don't see it work for my needs, but it all depends on your requirements, of course. Suppose you only send a newsletter or only have a specific group of people with the same needs who are in the same situation. In that case, you can send them the same autoresponder. But I don't see that happening in many situations or in many different businesses. Another thing is, you have unlimited landing pages and lead funnels, so that's nice. But I don't really like this basic plan without the automation feature. So in the plus plan, and that's the 2nd plan they offer, you get access to the automation builder, and you can make up to 5 workflows in total. So when someone on my website tries to opt in and download something, they need to tell me their situation. My physicists can either choose for bucket 1, 2, 3, or 4. It can be more or fewer buckets, whatever you want, of course. So to create personalized email content for each of the people in the buckets, you need to use the filter element called dynamic segment inside GetResponse. And in my opinion, this is not the most intuitive solution for segmenting your audience when they opt in, since it has a bit of a learning curve how this feature works. For example, in ConvertKit, it's a bit easier to do and understand. Check out my video where I compare these two products for all the details on that. So coming back to the Plus plan, you get access to the automation feature and you can create 5 workflows. And I think 5 workflows are pretty much enough, since you can make the example I gave with the 4 buckets of how I do it with my online dog training website just in 1 workflow. You can use the other 4 workflows for other purposes. The other features in the Plus plan are pretty much self-explanatory, so I'm not going to cover that in this video. The next plan, or the third plan, or as GetResponse calls it, the professional plan, offers more of what you already get in the Plus plan. These include unlimited automations and funnels, and some little extra webinar features. If you need a dedicated IP address or send transactional emails for your software application or e-commerce business, you need the 4th plan, their Max plan. But to be honest, if you're an e-commerce business or require transactional emails, GetResponse is not the tool for you. There are other tools built explicitly for e-commerce or transactional emails. I created both videos about the best email marketing tools for transactional emails or e-commerce businesses. So check those out if that's what you need. There are links in the description of this video below to those other videos. Okay, so now we're gonna start with the fun part. We're gonna show GetResponse's features and my opinion about them. So for this video, I tested the features of GetResponse I find most important. And the features I tested and I will discuss in this video are the first one, that's creating a newsletter. The second one is I made a form and landing page and automation to give away a free ebook. And the third one is I created automated emails. And the fourth one is I created a sign-up form for my website. And the fifth one is I created a webinar. And lastly, I contacted their support for questions to see how that went. Okay, so the first thing, creating a newsletter. Creating a campaign inside GetResponse is pretty straightforward. It works as it should work. One nice feature they have is creating and saving blocks. Time savers like this are pretty neat. Here you can see that they have probably listened to the customer's feedback and added the block feature. They didn't have that block feature from the beginning, I think. MailChimp, for instance, still doesn't have such a feature. And it's not a big problem, but these nice little features stack up. And if you have tons of those small time savers, I'm beginning to love the product more and more. Another nice feature they offer is sending your email at a specific time based upon your subscriber's time zone. Let's say you have a weekly newsletter and you want to send a newsletter each Sunday at 5 p.m. You can easily do this with GetResponse so that each subscriber will receive the email at 5 p.m. and it doesn't matter in what part of the world they are. This is probably another feature they implemented based upon customer feedback. So that means they're listening to their customers, which is, I find, pretty important. Lastly, if you're into pre-designed email templates, GetResponse has got you covered here, like most other email marketing software companies. They offer around 110 pre-designed templates for their newsletters, so you have plenty of options to choose from. So that's it, basically, for sending newsletters. All in all, looking pretty good. Okay, so the next thing, creating a form and landing page and automation to give away a free ebook. So now the fun part begins. One of the most used features inside an email marketing tool is the automation features, of course. One of the best ways to gain new email subscribers is to offer them something, like a free ebook with tips, for instance. And speaking of a free ebook with tips, if you want to know how I build an email list of more than 25,000 email subscribers with my online dog training business, make sure to download this free 5-page ebook where I share my 3-step formula to 100 daily newsletter signups. And there's a link to this free ebook in the description below. So, each email marketing tool has its own way of doing things. And the best way to deliver a free ebook inside GetResponse is to use their conversion funnel tool. The first thing you do here is you upload the ebook you created. And you can easily upload your ebook inside GetResponse. The next step is to create a sign-up page where people can sign up and download your ebook. And they offer around 10 pre-designed templates for your sign-up page, but you can also create one from scratch. And the cool thing about the pages is that you can rearrange, add and delete everything you would like. You can add YouTube videos, you can add buttons, you can add countdown timers, and many more things. There is an option to change everything you would like. You don't have to be a tech wizard to do these things either, as it can be done quickly by dragging and dropping. And if you have the ambition to A/B test your pages, you can easily do that too. And I'm not sure, but I think you can have an unlimited amount of tests. And I want to add to this that I would advise you to add a consent field for your signup box to ensure you stay GDPR compliant. The GDPR is the new European law telling you how to use and handle individuals' information, meaning every potential subscriber needs to know how their data is used. If there is a slight possibility you have European visitors on your website, you need to do this. And one way of doing this is to add a consent field to your signup box I just mentioned. And you can manually edit the text in a consent field to something like, when downloading this free ebook, you will also receive regular emails from me about email marketing tips and products we're offering. And it's up to you to make this a requirement to sign up or not. You can also link to your privacy policy page in the same consent. You can also choose not to make this a condition to sign up and not send them any marketing emails. You only send them the free ebook. GetResponse's tool is pretty flexible, so you can do whatever you like. When done with the sign up page, you move on to the next page, and that's a thank you page for the people who signed up. Same thing as before, you can easily change all the parts of the thank you page as well. When done with the thank you page, you can move on to the next step. In the next step, you can choose what URL you want the page to be, whether you want Google to index the page, and other things. When done, you click on publish. The next step is to create a download page for people to download the free ebook. Same thing as with other pages you create inside GetResponse, you can easily rearrange every block on the page and add all the things you want. You can add timers, videos, etc. And here again, you can create A/B tests if you want. And what's pretty cool I didn't mention yet is that they have specific mobile pages to edit. Since your mobile width is much smaller than your desktop, you probably want to change things up for your mobile version. And you can easily do this inside GetResponse. And to make sure you understand this mobile feature, this is not the same as responsiveness. Responsiveness means that the page or form scales with the width of the screen. Having a separate mobile version besides your desktop version means you can change the complete look and feel of it on mobile. Meaning you can delete specific sentences, images, videos, or whatever you want. So when done, you go to the next step, and again, you can say whether you want Google to index the page. And of course, you don't want the download page of your ebook indexed by Google, right? Because then people can just randomly Google your ebook and come to the download page of your ebook. And the cool thing about their conversion funnel builder is that you can see how it's performing. You can see how many visitors it's gotten and what the sign-up rate is. And you can also easily see how the other A/B test pages are doing. And eventually you can select a winner if you would like. And lastly, you want to test the funnel whether or not it's working. So make sure you fill in your own email address to check out if you like the process, how it works right now. That is how the funnel creation process works. It's one of the most intuitive solutions I've seen so far. Every piece is customizable, allowing you to change everything the way you would want it to be. And the cool thing is, you have unlimited lead funnels available with the basic plan, and that's the cheapest plan. Okay, so the next thing, creating automated emails. Besides distributing free ebooks and stuff to your new subscribers, you want to nurture your new subs by sending them pre-written newsletters, or in other words, an automated workflow. GetResponse has two ways of doing this. The first option is to use the autoresponders we've talked about before, which is included in the basic plan. And the second option is using their automation feature. So good to know their automation feature is only available in the plus plan, remember, and not in the basic plan. So what's exactly the difference between the automation feature and the autoresponder feature? Do you need the automation feature, or can you do pretty much the same thing with the autoresponder? Well, GetResponse has a page about the differences between the two features on the website, and they say this. Autoresponders are messages set to go out automatically in a sequence, one after the other, at regular intervals. They react to contact subscribing or being added to your list by import or manually. They don't have any other triggers or settings. With the automation feature, you can send automated messages that react to message sent, message opened, clicked links, contacts moved, or copied between lists. Added tags, assigned scores, page visits, abandonment cards, purchases, and many more things. The problem with not having the automation feature available in a basic plan is that you cannot send your list different messages based upon their situation. So again, remember what I said in the beginning, for my online dog training business, I have multiple sign-up forms where people can download either a checklist, free chapters of my book, free books, etc. The moment they sign up, I ask them about their situation, and they can choose one of the four situations or buckets I created. They can choose for either, I don't know if I'm ready for a puppy. The second one is, I'm ready for a puppy, but I don't know the breed yet. And the third one is, I'm waiting to pick up my puppy from the breeder. Or the last one, I have my puppy already at home. And by me knowing their situation, I can personalize my messages to them. I'm not going to send people information about different dog breeds if they already have their puppy at home. So yeah, you'll get this point, right? So it is impossible to do if you only use the autoresponder, since you cannot work with tags or other actions inside the autoresponder. You can only do one email sequence and that's it. And in my opinion, email marketing is all about the personalization and automation. And without one of these two, I don't see it work for my needs. But of course, it all depends what your specific requirements are. Suppose you only send out newsletters or only have a specific group of people with the same needs who are in the same situation. And in that case, you can send them the same autoresponder. But I don't see that happening in many situations. I do want to mention that GetResponse have dozens of templates to get ideas from to use inside your email marketing. And secondly, you can easily use these templates yourself, of course, by easily importing them into your account. Thirdly, if you're not sure what that specific template does, you can read an article about it where they explain it. They have a very detailed help center so you can become a pro at automation. One thing they could improve upon is adding more video tutorials to their help center. Especially with software, it's sometimes hard to understand when there are text-only explanations. Another thing I think they should add is adding pre-written content to those templates. For example, if you import one of the welcome email templates, it should give you different ideas on what you can write about in those welcome emails. Having pre-written email templates helps you jumpstart your email marketing since you don't have to come up with everything yourself. For example, MailChimp does this a little bit. And I know for a fact that ConvertKit does this pretty good. It's not that they spit out everything you need to write, word for word, but they give you some bullet points and ideas. I think it's an excellent way to help your customers, us, the people using the software. So again, if you're not sure what the automation tool does precisely, you can take a look at those different templates. These templates will definitely spark some ideas in you. So the next thing, I created a sign-up form for my website. So a sign-up form is simply a form saying, join my newsletter, for instance. Using these words, join my newsletter, probably won't result in the highest conversion rate, but that's not the point here. The goal here is me testing the feature and whether or not I can easily create professionally looking sign-up forms, edit them and publish them on my website if I have one. So in short, creating a sign-up form inside GetResponse works like a charm. And I can easily embed it on my WordPress website by using the JavaScript code they provide. I just copy and paste this code into the sidebars of my WordPress website or in one of the widgets as WordPress calls it. If you don't have a website, you can host a form on GetResponse as well, but that's not something I would advise. You're better off creating a landing page instead if you don't have a website. So the same with the landing pages. I can create different opt-in forms versions to A/B test. I also can easily edit the thank you page of the form. And the cool thing about GetResponse's forms and landing pages is that you can edit it however you want it to look. It's just so flexible, you can drag and drop and move every little thing. They also offer lots of different pre-designed templates for the forms, so you will find a design that suits your needs. So yes, looking good. Okay, so the next thing, doing webinars. So creating a webinar with GetResponse is pretty easy and straightforward. The cool thing with the webinar tool is that they integrated it with their other features like the landing pages, meaning you can create those flexible, customizable landing pages to send traffic to for signing up for your webinar. Demio, for example, a laser-focused webinar tool, doesn't have the flexibility with their webinar landing pages. But on the other hand, I feel Demio will win if you compare who's got a better and more intuitive webinar solution. Maybe that's a cool idea for a new video. Demio vs GetResponse, where I'll compare all these features in depth. Having a webinar feature is nice, and you can try it out if you're into webinars, since webinar software usually is pretty expensive. With Demio, for instance, you pay $49 each month for using the software. And with that, you only have a 50 attendee room. The next plan is 150 attendee room, and you pay $99 per month. GetResponse offers the webinar feature inside the second plan, and that's the plus plan. You'll have a 100 attendee room inside this plan, which is pretty cool. The plan starts at $49 per month for 1,000 contacts. And if you need more than 100 attendees, you will need the professional plan, which starts at $99. So if you're into doing monthly webinars, it's worth looking into GetResponse. So I think that's pretty much it of all the features I'm testing and talking about in this video. Lastly, one more thing. I contacted their support through chat 2 times. One time during the week and another time on a Saturday. And I must say, this works like a charm. They responded with a few minutes. And I like that software companies have a chat feature available 24/7, because you don't want to search the web for answers when working on a software tool if you're stuck. You want a helping hand that can quickly get you back on track, making those productive hours to earn the daily bread. Okay, so the last part of this video, how much money does GetResponse make per day? So we're coming to an end here, and if you're still with me, then you've come a long way. Thanks, brother, for sticking with me this long. I appreciate it. So to cut to the chase, as we Dutch people like it. So according to a podcast interview in 2018 with CEO and founder Simon of GetResponse, they earned close to $7,000 per hour in recurring revenue. 24 hours a day and 7 days per week, meaning they make around $5 million in revenue each month. So they had 100,000 paying customers back in 2018. And when I browse their about page now in 2020, they write having 350,000 customers worldwide. And I'm not sure if these 350,000 customers are all paying customers though, because they spoke in that same podcast interview from 2018, having 2,000 new daily trials for their software. So it could be that of those 350,000 customers, 60,000 or so are on their 30-day monthly trial plan. But then again, they have grown immensely. So Simon bootstrapped GetResponse with only $200 at age 18 in his parents' attic. So it's a pretty cool story. Google it if you're interested in it. In this same podcast interview, Simon explains GetResponse growth of 20% year over year. He feels that their growth comes from adding new features to their software, such as the marketing automation feature we've discussed early in the video, landing pages, and the webinar tool. In his words, they move from being solely an email marketing tool to more of a marketing platform. And GetResponse is not the only one seeing the benefits of moving from a sole email marketing company to more of an all-in-one marketing platform. MailChimp, for instance, switched last year in March, out of the top of my head, from being an email marketing platform to an all-in-one marketing platform. MailChimp added lots of different features as well, besides their email marketing tool. And one of the last questions asked, what if you could sell the company for $240 million? Would you do it?
If you're doing around $60 million a year in revenue and Benioff comes to you and offers you 4 times that or $240 million, do you sell the company?
No.
Really?
No, really. Yeah.
You said that quickly.
I am just not. Yeah, I'm not looking to sell the company. I just love what we're doing so much. There is no intention to sell.
His words were that he loves what he's doing so much that there is no intention to sell. And I really like this response, since it says something about Simon's motivation and determination to create something extraordinary for his customers. So my final words before we wrap up. So whether or not GetResponse is something worth spending your time and money on totally depends on what you're looking for in an email marketing automation tool. So if you want to try out GetResponse for free, please do so by going through my affiliate link below. It's in the description, as I will receive a small commission when you do so, with no extra cost to you, of course. And remember, if you go through my affiliate link, that will be the end of it. But if you don't,
I will rain down on a godly f-ing firestorm upon you. You're going to have to call the f-ing United Nations and get a f-ing binding resolution to keep me from f-ing destroying you.
I'm talking spam email, mother f-ing. I will send you spam email. And one more last thing before we wrap things up. I spent the last month or two researching and testing dozens of different email marketing tools, and I spent hundreds of hours on this. I created a video where I shared my findings on what tool is best in my opinion. Check out the description for a link to that video. In the description below, you also find links to other videos, such as videos where I compare GetResponse with other email marketing tools like MailChimp. You can find those video links in the description below. Please click the like button if you find this video of any value to you before you go. And if you didn't find any value in this video, then please let me know as well, as I would like to know whether or not I'm doing a good job here. Also, please leave me a comment and explain why you are interested in GetResponse. On what project are you working? Furthermore, if you have any questions regarding email marketing, please let me know. I would love to help you, and I would love to give you some tips. And since I don't have any subscribers yet to my YouTube channel, you have my full attention. And lastly, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking the big red subscribe button so you won't miss my next video. Because every Monday and every Thursday, there's a new video where I'll publish my research on a new software tool, or where I share invaluable tips related to email marketing or other cool bread making subjects. And if you want to know how I built my email list of more than 25,000 email subscribers with my online dog training business, make sure to download this free 5-page ebook where I share my 3-step formula to 100 daily newsletter signups. There's a link to the free ebook in the description below. So that's all I got to say for today. Stay hydrated, stay healthy, and good luck with your journey to earning that daily bread for you and your family. Thanks for watching my video, brothers, and I'll see you next time. Robin out.